So let's continue. So here you can see in this PPT, we have a dedicated team, your developer team, who is working on this project. They are going to develop the code for this project. Not code, other things also. If it is a Docker related thing, they are going to develop the Docker file, or also with the help of your ops team, they are going to develop the Ansible files as well, playbooks. So a lot of things are there. So I'm going to discuss all of them. So as of now, just for your understanding, there is a team, a developer team who is working on this project. Now they need one location where they can write the code. So obviously the developer team is going to write the code from their local system, that is your laptop. So on your local system, each developer, they have to download one software, that is Git Bash for Windows. And also they need one repository or one remote location where they can push their code. So you have to create your account into the GitHub, and then you have to create one repository for your project. So whosoever developer is working for their project, at the end of the day, they can push their code to your GitHub repository. So let me first download the Git Bash software for Windows. Suppose this is the laptop of your developer and they want to start working for this project. So very first step, they have to download the Git Bash. So go to the Google and search with download Git Bash for Windows. Click on the first link, and this is for Windows machine. And then click on this 64-bit for Windows setup. Now here you can see it is started downloading. Perfect. Let me open this one. And then you have to install this software on your laptop. It won't take much time, hardly 1 or 2 minutes. So basically, this Git Bash software is required for the developers to push their files or codes from the local system to the remote location, or vice versa. Finish. Now you just need to create one directory in your local system. Let me go to this E drive and right click new folder, and I'm giving the name Kubernetes project. You can give any name. Just go inside this directory and right click here and click on this show more options, and here we have this Git Bash here. So this software we have installed just now. Click on it. So here you can see the location of this Git Bash. Just fire pwd command. So it is showing that you are inside this project. And as of now, there is nothing. Next step, you have to create an account in the GitHub. Let me show you. Go to github.com. And if you do not have an account, just click on sign up. I'm already having an account, so let me log into this account. And here you can see in the left hand side, we have one icon that is new. So I want to create one repository for my project so that the developers, they can push their code to this repository. And here I'm giving the name Kubernetes Jenkins project. You can give any name, it is up to you. Perfect. I want it should be public, and I want to add a readme file here and create a repository. So this repository has been created, and this is the URL of this repository. Next step, you have to clone this repository from this location to your local system. Clone means you just want to copy this repository, the entire repository, to your local machine. So how we can do that? Let me come back here. I'm in this location, and let me show it from here as well. So as of now, you can see there is nothing inside this directory. Perfect. Now let me clone. So the command is git clone, and then you have to give the URL of your repository. Paste. So I got this repository from here. This is the repository. Enter. It is just cloning. So whatever we have in this repository, it is just copying from here and pasting into the local system. Now coming back here. Now here you can see one directory has been created. This one. And as of now, there is nothing, only one readme file. Coming back here. And ls-ltr. So one directory has been created, and this directory is your repository name. So let me go inside this one, and here you can see one file is there. So that's all. We'll see you in the next lecture.